Welcome to Economics Class. Today we will learn about market economies. A market economy is also known as capitalism. In this system, the majority of economic decisions are not made by the government. They are made by the people. If the decisions were made by one person or a small group of people, we would call this a centralized system. But because the economic decisions are made by many individual people, we call it a decentralized system. In other words, every time an individual decides to buy or sell something, they participate in the economic decision-making process. They are helping decide the answers to the big economic questions of what to produce, how much to produce, and who will produce it. Because economic decisions are made by the individual buyers and sellers, a driving force behind the market economy is price competition. It forces businesses to supply goods and services people want and sell those goods and services at prices lower than their competitors, but high enough to make a profit. In general, all market economies share some traits. People are free to own property. In fact, individuals own most businesses. And people are free to run any type of lawful business. The government has limited control, so people have economic freedom of choice. Also, people and businesses are free to compete. The concept of a market economy was proposed by Scottish economist Adam Smith in his 1776 book, The Wealth of Nations. Smith lived in Europe during the Industrial Revolution, when a large percentage of the population lived in cities and worked in dangerous factories for low wages. Despite these struggles, Smith believed the economy would eventually solve its own problems. He believed that the government should have a limited role in the economy because it is best for individuals to decide and do what is best for themselves. For example, Smith believed that if a wealthy factory owner makes more money, he will build more factories, provide more jobs, and benefit society overall. Similarly, if a factory worker wants a better-paying job, he will improve his skills until he can get a better job, thus benefiting himself and his family. Smith also wrote about a concept he described as the invisible hand. The idea was that with competition among individuals, together with free market principles, the economy would be guided by an invisible hand that would guide resources to their most productive use. In other words, the economy should be free from government control and allowed to work itself out. Smith had a name for this, laissez-faire economics, which is French for leave it alone. While the United States does use many of Adam Smith's principles, there is government involvement in the economy, and this comes directly from the U.S. Constitution. The preamble of the U.S. Constitution states, "Its goal is to promote the general welfare." Thus, the government has always taken a larger role in the economy than Smith probably would have recommended. For example, we have a minimum wage, laws against dangerous machinery, and laws that say children must go to school instead of work. Overall, market economies have advantages and disadvantages. Advantages include the system is flexible and efficient. It helps make sure the most needed goods and services are provided, and it encourages economic growth. It also allows for individual freedom and choice. In general, high-quality goods are produced, and competition tends to keep prices down. Disadvantages include the economy only rewards productive labor. In other words, it doesn't meet the needs of those too old, too young, or too sick to take care of themselves. The rewards of wealth are also uneven. Society produces many luxury goods, but there are still people who do not make enough money to support themselves. Additionally, the economy can go through periods of growth and then recession, where it becomes unstable and people suffer economic losses. Thus, the market economy of the United States can be highly complex. It is based primarily on free enterprise, which means individuals are free to choose how to use their resources and private property. For example, Americans can choose what type of job to have and where to work. They can also decide to open their own businesses. They have a say in how much money they earn and how they spend that money. While the government makes some economic decisions, most are made in the marketplace.